guys, New 2000 here, and welcome back to some more Subnautica, where I fixed up the life pod. And, we have a bunch of, singles. So we have life pod 4, here, let me get up here. So we have life pod 4 all the way over there. Recommended investigation, it says. Then we have life pod 3, crew reported their sea glide damaged. And then... what else is the... okay, here it is. Let's take that. And we also have life pod 17, where crew reported the Seamoth Bay collapsed around them. So I think we should go to the Seamoth Bay. Because it seems really important. Also, I made the sea glide, but whenever I put it away, it does this. And there's also this. So let's scan ourselves again. Can't really see anything. Okay then. That was a bit weird. Also, did a lot of mining. All that sorts of stuff. So I'm thinking of also starting our base. So I have this. So just put this away. So yeah, I have this locker. But I thought I had more stuff in it. But apparently not. That's a bit weird. But so let's see here. So Seamoth. So that's the Seamoth right there. And so I think we can make our radiation suit. So fiber mesh and lead. Where do we get fiber mesh? Let me see where we get fiber mesh from. Silicon rubber. Silicon rubber won't be that hard for us, so I think we should go make ourselves a radiation suit. Let's just survey the area. Not for any danger. I've yet to see anything dangerous. So you know what, let's just go in there quickly. Great, let's go for this one. Great, where am I going? I'm going over here. I don't know why it was pushing me that way. So that was easy. Shit, I forgot to take this out. Great. Okay, so it said silicone rubber, right? Okay, yep, silicone rubber and some titanium. Alright. How much titanium is that? Okay, that's all it needed. So let's go ahead and make a knife.
A new message has arrived.
Okay, hold on. Take out the knife. Look a lot better if my hand isn't so glitched out.
This is Avery Quinn of Trading Ship Sunbeam. Aurora, do you read? Over. Still nothing. These old Terra ships, they've run out of engine grease. They send an SOS. You offer to help? made him pick up. Aurora, I'm out on the far side of the system. It's going to take more than a week to reach your position. Do you still need our assistance? Over. I'll try them again tomorrow. See what the long-range scan picks up in the meantime. Damn Charter's gonna have us wasting our profit margin running errands for Altera.
Okay, so... Sunbeam, huh? That same... I hope the same thing doesn't happen to them. But so, weapons were removed from standard survival blueprints following the massacre on Obraxis Prime. As an essential survival tool for 2.5 million years, the knife remains the only exception. Sorry about that. What the hell happened on Obraxis Prime? Why do we have to suffer? I'm on an alien planet. Kind of bullshit. But alright, so I also made a bunch of beacons for a lot of important stuff, like new areas, all that type of stuff. So we got a lot of lead here. Needed fiber mesh. I wonder what that is. So yeah, let's just grab the lead. Wanted two lead. Then I guess we can put these in here. We don't need all of those. So let's grab some water. And we can also put our repair tool. Nah. Let's keep the repair tool on us and then we'll put the coordinates in there. That should be in. Should help us a lot with space. I want to see what we can do with the knife. I think we can make water by grabbing this. First of all, I think we need to make bleach. Don't ask me how that makes sense and why we're moving so slowly. I think it might be because we have a lot of stuff in our pockets. So I believe the knife has a durability on it. Okay, that's scary. Give us back the sun. Also, sorry if I seem out of it. I'm really tired. Like, I wasn't even able to get out of bed today. My body hurt when I was trying to get out of bed today. So if I just seem out of it, that's the reason why. I'm really not feeling good. But anyways, let's just try and keep on finding some more. I think we need this also. So let me look at how we need to make bleach. We're gonna drink bleach and die. Probably the best way to get out instead of getting eaten by a giant monster. Drink bleach. But alright, so here's bleach, so common coal samples. So wait, hold on. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me go grab some more air. Or breathe in some. Shush. So this should help us a lot. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's go ahead and find some more. And we'll also go down and get some fiber mesh, wherever we get that from. I believe it's from the kelp forest. I think that's where we get fiber mesh from. I can't find any. So I wonder if this will work. Like if we could cut our food and then bring it with us. Oh, here's some more for another salt deposit. Let's go cut this up. There we go. Now we can go make some more bleach. You know what? Let's just take out our sea glide. You know what? Let's take these things with us. There's a lot of acid mushrooms. So why on top of this? Oh, my inventory is full. Crap. I think it's very weird that it's on top of those. Alright, so here we go. Collect some bleach. Should be able to make 5 bleach. Yep, there we go. Now wait, hold on. Now we can make some disinfected water from bleach. Preparing the day's water ration ahead of time will help ensure against dehydration and eventual death. Yay, that's good. Now look at how low our water is. We also need to find an alternative food source. Instead of these fish. Then bleach is an essential chemical used for cleaning wounds and purifying water. Don't really think that's how it's used. What it's used for. I don't know why it's so far away. But let's just go ahead and put all this stuff in here. And let's also put all our disinfected water in there. Now let's also get some whatever the hell fiber mesh is. There we go. Also, I think we get. Okay, so we got three new things. So we can make a dive reel, a rebreather, and fiber mesh. Alright. So let's go make some fiber mesh. And so a rebreather vinyl kit, dive reel. Go ahead and make a radiation suit. And look at that. Wait a minute, hold on. How do we make fins? I think we also need a bunch of fins. Silicon rubber times 2. Come on. Now let's go make some silicone rubber. We also now need to go get some more. Whatever the hell this stuff even is. Hold on a minute. Let's go back. I Then you go hunting for the one that's the safest. It looks sort of like this one. Get the fuck out of here. God, I always hate going in there. It's so scary.
Aurora, this is Sunbeam again. We just picked up a massive debris field at your location. I didn't know how bad. How many of... I didn't know. We're now en route to your location. We're gonna bring you home. Sunbeam out. What else can I say? We're a six-seater, and we aren't even slightly equipped to handle this. Our pilot last attempt at a planet landing in the Academy simulator. Oh, it's a bad situation, but so are all the alternatives.
Huh? All right, so it looks like they're having a bit of trouble. Just like we are. What else needs to come out? Power cell? Alright, so... let's go ahead and make some food. Let's go grab these two. Like cooked goldfish and a cooked gammonfish. I wonder if the gravisphere. No organisms, alright. Really not liking what's going on right now. Oh, nope, I didn't mean to do that. Shit. I meant to open the storage. Okay, never mind. We're not using this. It's buggy. So, spent all that time and I feel dumb now. Why did it all go away? Well, I guess we should go to the Seamoth Bay place. Alright. So that made no sense. Oh, this place looks scary. Oh, this place does not look nice. I'm just going straight in there. Fuck it. Well, this place does not look nice at all.
Integrating new PDA data.
Let's go get some more air. Oh, but that place looks so scary. There's something right over here. Go ahead and scan it. So here, let's look at this. Not that. Data downloads, LifePod. So let's read this. LifePod made planetfall intact approximately 1 hour ago. Environmental instruments were knocked offline when the Aurora Seamoth Bay collapsed around me. With my face pressed to the glass, I can make out shadows shifting about in the water below me. Every so often, the pod is rocked by some kind of collision. I can't tell whether the pod is bumping up against the rocks or if there is something out there that's trying to get in. Either way, the hull is beginning to buckle. I can see what's left of the Aurora from the top hatch. We were carrying anything and everything we might need to complete the phase gate. Mobile vehicle bays, bioreactors, propulsion cannons. I'm going to go out there and scavenge whatever I can find. See if I can find or reinforce the life pod hull. Okay, so that guy pretty much died. So let's read about the Seamoth. So, the Seamoth is a one-person submersible with an independent replaceable power cell and a fully customizable design. Most long-range mining vessels carry at least two submersibles of this water-bearing planetoids. Alright. Wait, hold on. Alright, so ratings, top speed 13 mile MS, acceleration 5, distance per power cell 10 km, crush depth 200 meters below sea level, upgrade module slots 4, dimensions 3m times 1.5m times 1m, persons 1. Seamoth may be modified by installing upgrade modules to the access point mounted by default on the upper left wing. These include increased cargo storage, superior power, pressure and collision compensation, enhanced sonar, defensive capabilities. These modules may only be manufactured at an appropriately outfitted moon pool. Alright. So again, a bit scary. But I'm gonna figure out what's making that noise. I can still hear it. It's annoying the crap out of me. What the hell is that? Well, there's two of them. Look in the distance. I'm gonna turn this off. So there's something over there, a wreckage. Look at these! That thing's huge! Oh, hell no. You get? There's so many of them. No, I'm gonna go to the small one. I'm gonna scan him. A reef back. Wow, you're for a big guy, you're fast. So let's read this data down. Oh my god, stop it. Oh my god, stop. Alright, so let's read the PDA download. So life forms, fauna, herbivores, reef back. So, okay, so that's what the kind of creepy. Limited data available. One, continuous plating. So there's one thick enough to interfere with this spectroscope scanner. Two, unidentified pods. It's unknown purpose, green in color, visual similarity to the gastropod's algae gland. Three, tentacles. Total length ranges upwards of 25 millimeters. Tentacles provide low speed propulsion. Actually, I think that's 25 meters. Sociable, seen traveling in small pods, behavior consistent with low-level sentient. Predators unknown. Assessment, additional data required. Okay, well that's... that's a bit creepy to know. At least for me it is. I don't know about you guys. This place is especially creepy. What the hell happened here? Is this part of the Aurora? Well, of course it is. Why would I even need to ask that? I'm gonna try and get closer to it. There's gotta be some stuff in here. It's worth scanning. I'm gonna try and see if there's an entrance somewhere. They did say that this was the, Hey, look at this. This is an entrance. What are you? Bioreactor fragment. I heard something scary out there. Desk. Chair 3. And just a chair. Battery charger fragment. One of two. Shit, I need to go grab some more. Here we go.
30 seconds.
Thank you for reminding me. I heard something. a bench.
New blueprint acquired.
Is that seriously it? Oh wait, nope. There's something. Something scary, that's for sure. Yes, water. I needed water. Jesus, that scared me. So that place definitely got wrecked. But no. There's a floodlight?
New blueprint acquired.
Steel suit fragment. Seamoth fragment. So we need how many? 3. Okay, so we just need one more. Shoot, if I don't hurry, I'm gonna be dead.
New blueprint acquired. 30 seconds.
Shit. I don't even know where I came out of.
Oxygen.
Shit, I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it. I got some air, that's for sure. Let's go and look for some more stuff. Sit. Or anything. Battery charger fragment. Already have that. What about my flashlight? It's really dark in here. Doesn't seem nice at all. This surely is a lot of stuff to scan. Is this the final fragment? Yes, see my fragment. What's up with the art? These things. Seamoth fragment.
30 seconds.
Oh shit, I'm not gonna make it. Shit, I'm not gonna make it, I'm not gonna make it, I'm not gonna make it.
Oxygen.
Shit, I'm not gonna make it. Shit, I'm not gonna make it. Fuck. No! Well, hopefully, we have all the fragments. Yes, we still have all the fragments. So, titanium ingot. powerful glass lubricant. Alright. So I guess we can make Degassi. Search and rescue Auxiliary search and rescue target Margaret Maida. Position, security, personal stats, lost in space, or radiant arm. Age at time of disappearance, 42. Damn, she was old. Freelance mercenary born in the Mongolian states. Experienced in ship-to-ship and close-quarters combat techniques. Tours of duty with Mongolian Defense Force at the Trans-System Federation. Dishonorably discharged from the TSF 15 years ago for going off mission details. Classified missionary Kassar reports Maida was hired to accompany Paul Torgau aboard the Degassi into uncharted space and defend the ship in case of pirate assault. Alright, well, steel suit. Okay, so the industry standard steel suit is designed to minimize water loss while exploring hostile environments by filtering and recycling body fluids. The steel suit because drinking reclaimed urine is better than death by dehydration. That's helpful but kind of disgusting. Reclaimed water is stored in containers for later consumption. Normal production rate is 2 bottles per day. Filters contaminants from no less than 4 different bodily excretions. I don't know how to say that word. Shut up. Blood and sweat may be effectively processed, upgrade to Mark II to make the most of tears. Onboard flavor neutralizer can be activated at startup. Flavor neutralizer not included on all models. Alright, so habitats, floodlight, power bioreactor. Alright, well, what are we? Oh! Titanium ingot, lubricant, power cell. Alright, so let's go make a titanium ingot. How do we make a titanium ingot? Ten titanium, alright. Let's actually put this away. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so there's 5 of those. And then let's go find some more titanium. Ooh, wow, that's a giant piece. It also looks like that. I don't want to hurt you. I've had some troubles with those guys. The crash fish, they're not really nice at all. But anyways, I should just keep trying to keep on finding some more titanium. We can try and find. Oh, hey, look at that. We got titanium from that. God damn it, my inventory is full. So that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we got 7. Well, let's just swim back to the life pod. Also, I was thinking of naming it Wilson. Because for some reason it reminds me of the volleyball from whatever, I forget what the movie is. Castaway, I believe? I think it's Castaway. Yeah, but I mean, it reminds me a lot of it. I think I may just name it George. Yeah, you know, let's just name it George, I think. For copyright reasons. Just for reasons. Alright. Let's go ahead and make some titanium. Let's go make some more titanium. Let's go make a titanium ingot. Stop titanium ingot. Yeah, I already know that. So now we just need lubricant. A power cell. How do we make power cell? Oh yeah, that's right. Get close to this one. Wait, no. I'm gonna switch too close to the ground. Oh yeah, I can't see anything. I said we go for this one. See you later. And so now we got enough to make some lubricant, and hopefully we actually have 5. One for lubricant, and one for some fiber mesh. Wait, no, silicone rubber, I believe. So let's take that out and make some food. First of all, let's make the food. Cooked hoop fish. And now, oh, we only have 3. Shit. Let's make the lubricant. Okay, so we got room for 2. Hold on, how do we make, so here, we need to make a power cell now. So we need 2 batteries, okay. Wait, why did I do that? Alright. We only have 1. So I got 4 acid mushrooms so that we can make 2 batteries, but can't make one yet until I find another copper. Oh Okay, where can we find more copper? I think I already dug up all this. Yeah. Never mind with that one. Looks like day is also coming. There we go. Let's try. Oh! Please be copper, please be copper, please be copper. Yes! Pick up copper. So let's grab. Stab that. Stabbed it. I missed a stabby. Stab. I'll stab you. I'll cut you. Alright, so one step closer to getting a Seamoth. And I say we go explore the Aurora in the next episode once we get our Seamoth. So this will be a long episode. I really don't want to edit this video. I cut it down because there's so much stuff in it. Don't know what I can really do. But yeah, I just say that I'm not going to edit it. So we got some disinfected water. And let's go make 2 batteries. Also put the med kits away. That's kind of a stupid choice. Let's go. Go grab some more. That's the only close one. Fuck it, I'm out. Because I'm also thinking of building our base in the safe shallows. It's because it seems really safe there. And we have nothing to worry about. I think that's enough to make it. Yes, it is. Alright, here we go, guys. Wait a minute, hold on. Let me make sure that I have enough space. Now I think I might have enough space. Well, hold on, how much? What do we need to build a Seamoth? And a prawn? Oh, we also need glass. Oh, wait, no, that's for the Seamoth. So we need titanium ingot, power cell, lubricant, glass. Wait, it did say silicone rubber, right? No, it said lubricant. And power cell. Alright, so for a power cell we need silicon. Alright, so here, you want, I'll make this into some silicon rubber just to clear up some space. Okay, there we go. Now we should have enough room. Yes, we do. Hopefully we have enough room. And look at that thing, it's big. Wow, that takes up a lot of space. Damn. So we have another part of our okay, we're drifting. We were drifting, okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, so guys, I think I will end the episode here. Subscribe for more, leave a like for more, and tell me what you want in the comments below for next time, and I will do it. And guys, I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye!